Hello friends, today's tutorial is all about how to make a bonsai tree. In the stage 1, we will going to learn how to repot a bonsai tree and then we will build a beautiful landscape around your bonsai pot. You are watching me on Bonsai Tricks and a lot more. So let's start. Friends, do you remember the concrete pot or cemented bonsai pot which I have built earlier? I am going to use this homemade bonsai pot, but first sand the edges. Friends, if you haven't yet seen the video on how to make a bonsai pot, then you can visit my channel Bonsai Tricks and a lot more. The bonsai pot making video will be available there. Now as the edges become smooth, let's proceed to next step. I am using a plastic net as drainage skin for the bonsai pot. This is just an ordinary mosquito net. Now I am adding bonsai soil at the bottom. This coop was made by me just using a plastic bottle. I have cut it at an angle. Now friends, if you want the video on how to make bonsai soil, then you can check my channel, Bonsai Soil Making video is available there. Now let's start the repotting. Today I am going to work on this kapok tree and turn it into a beautiful bonsai. If you are using a plastic pot just like me, then please wrap the outer side with aluminium foil because roots doesn't like sunlight. The plant is nearly 1 year old and I have grown it from a cutting. Now I am losing the outer side of the soil so it doesn't damage the root ball when I am going to drag it out from the bonsai pot. I am using the back side of the fork for this process. Friends, do it slowly and take your time, otherwise you may damage the root ball. Let's pull it out. Now I am pulling it out gently. Friends, can you see the wonderful root ball? A bonsai tree cannot survive in a small bonsai pot until it has very good and dense root structure. A good quality root structure can be achieved by regular root pruning. Friends, I am combing the root with a homemade root rake which I have made from an ordinary fork. Friends, as I am always saying, that root pruning or radial root structure is very necessary for bonsai process. A plant wouldn't look like a full grown plant until it has developed a good quality surface root. Good quality surface root can be achieved by combing out the roots in radially outward direction. Now friends, let me shorten the height of the plant. I am going to cut the second branch about the height of the first branch. A hard pruning can always be done during repotting. Now let me decide where should I trunk chop the plant. If I cut the plant there, the new shoot will come out from a radially outward direction. So I think this should be the height of the cut. Now let's do some work on the root. Now you can see that the roots are larger, so I have to cut some of the roots. And it is just like cutting your hair. If your hair gets too long, then you have to cut it. So you also have to cut the roots of the bonsai as well. Cut it evenly and equally. I am cutting it nice and clean to give a beautiful root structure around the bonsai pot. Now let's soak the bonsai soil first. I am soaking the bonsai soil with my homemade watering can. Now I will show you how to make a watering can. Now many people complains that bonsai is a costly hobby, but you can make many of the bonsai tools at home. It is an ordinary oil jug. I have drilled a big hole there and you can control the flow by holding a finger over the hole. Isn't it cheap but great idea? The water must drain through a good quality bonsai soil within few seconds. You can see that the water is running out clearly from the bonsai soil. To increase the height of the plant, I am building a small mound with some bonsai soil, and then I am going to plant our bonsai over the mound. The pH of the soil plays a very important role in bonsai making process or all over your plant's health. So you have to test the pH of the soil first. If you don't have costly equipment to test the pH of the soil, you can visit my channel Bonsai Tricks and a lot more. A easy and cheap and homemade useful way to make pH strip at home is available there. Now I am inserting the soil in the gap of the roots, otherwise air pocket may build up and that will damage your root structure. Friends, do you remember that we have built two types of bonsai soil, one with perlite and one without one, and I am using the mixture with perlite in this process. Now I am flattening out the upper surface of the bonsai soil with a spatula. Because I am going to build a landscape around the bonsai pot, so first we have to level the bonsai soil, otherwise the moss won't grow on the soil and air pocket will live between moss and soil, so that will dry up your moss so quickly. Now I am spraying clean water on the upper surface of the bonsai soil to make it wet. I am not using our watering can since it will damage the plain surface of the bonsai soil and we won't be able to apply moss on the soil. I am making the soil upper surface more flatter. Otherwise, all the moss will dry out within few days. So flatten the surface very well if you want to apply green moss on the surface of the bonsai soil. Now let's talk about some of the characteristic features of our bonsai plant. Friends, you can see that our plant has very good trunk flow line and it has a wonderful or phenomenal taper and a very good structure or movement of the cap. After pruning, a wonderful canopy will be developed over the plant and the plant will look great. Now I am collecting some green moss which has grown on a old wall with a spatula. Many people wonders why all bonsai enthusiastic or bonsai lovers use green moss instead of grass. Friends, grass would look too large in the scale of a bonsai plant. For me, bonsai is a miniature replica of full-grown plant that we find in nature. Green moss looks exactly like grass, so it would look great in the bonsai pot and make your plant to look even larger. I am using the moss and pressing it gently in the soil, so a good contact between moss and soil developed and that will prevent the moss from drying up. I am using two types of moss and pressing it gently. I am going to take care very well of the moss, otherwise the moss would get dried up. Many people think that growing moss around your bonsai pot is too difficult, but friend, I say that growing moss around your bonsai pot isn't that difficult. You have to use some trick. Now, the trick number one, you have to soak the moss in a bucket full of water overnight before applying on the bonsai soil. Now, the trick number two is you have to press the moss gently with your finger. And trick number three, never use strong fertilizer over your bonsai plant. Always use a mild fertilizer. Use fertilizer daily but in small quantity. Now here comes the trick number four. Friends, never overwater your plant, otherwise your moss will be rotted in the process. On an intense sunny day, spray the moss with water and that will help the moss to live longer. Friends, I am going to soon upload a video on a 100 bonsai and I have grown moss over the top of the soil previous year and the moss is still growing healthy and steadily. If you take care of the moss, you never have to plant the moss again until repotting. Friends, I have seen so many YouTube videos that many bonsai artists, even some professional, use just one kind of moss around the bonsai pot. Friends, my question is, would it look natural? I am using two types of moss to give a natural look over your bonsai plant. Friends, if you like, you can use some rock to enhance the scenery. But don't overdo it, use 2 or 3 rocks around a small bonsai pot. If your bonsai pot is larger, then you can use some more of the rocks. Now I am using some play sand, ordinary play sand with spoon to make it look more natural. I am adding with small quantity at a time. You don't have to be precise in this process. You can overlap the moss with some sand. When we are going to spray water over the sand will be settled in the bottom of the plant and the moss, and all the moss, plant and sand will blend together to give it like a wonderful natural look. Now I am sprinkling some of the sand over the mosses too. It would look natural. Friends, I have forgotten to mention one thing at the beginning. Do you like my video? Is it helpful to you? If yes, then please consider subscribing. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to get the notification whenever I upload a video on YouTube. Now I am spraying with clean water. Friends, can you see that the two kinds of moss, the rock, the sand is just blending all wonderfully together? Isn't it look natural? The 10 days period after repotting is very crucial for your plant. So friends, please take a good care of your bonsai plant in this period. Friends, isn't a beautiful plant? The plant would look more beautiful after even more years. One of my subscribers named Mo has gifted me the wonderful chair. She has a very good YouTube channel. Friends, if you like, you can check out her YouTube channel. It is called Mo's Magic. I am using the chair underneath the tree. Isn't it looking beautiful? Friends, please like, comment and share, and don't forget to subscribe my channel for regular update. I am Oyon from Bonsai Tricks and a lot more. Thank you.